Real Madrid's La Liga title defence, it is fair to say, is hanging by a thread. The reigning champions are 6 points behind leaders Atletico, but it could very easily be a lot more than that because they are not playing well and have been rescued by late goals in three consecutive league games. At home to Real Sociedad a couple of weeks ago, the lifeline came from an 89th minute equaliser by Vinicius Junior. Then came the Madrid derby at the Wanda Metropolitano, where Karim Benzema struck to rescue a valuable point with 2 minutes of normal time remaining. And finally, last weekend, Benzema was again the hero, scoring twice, including a magnificent 92nd minute winner to turn a 1-0 deficit at home to Elche into a 2-1 victory. Without those late goals, Real would now be 12 points off top spot, and their chances of taking the title would be effectively over. The urgent need for those last-gasp strikes was a result of the team's generally ineffective attacking play, because Los Blancos have been badly struggling for goals, and often even for decent chances. Against Real Sociedad, their only effort on target, aside from Vinicius's late strike, was a hopeful long-range effort from Luka Modric. And against Elche, visiting keeper Edgar Badia was only forced into 2 saves, aside from Benzema's brace. It is clearly unsustainable for Zinedine Zidane's team to continually create so few chances and have to rely on late heroics to salvage points. Sooner or later, those vital goals at the death will surely stop arriving, and they will need to start gaining more convincing victories. Real's problems in the attacking department have dogged them throughout this calendar year. So far in 2021, they've played 15 games in all competitions, and Tuesday's win over Atalanta was only the second time they've scored more than twice in a game. Overall, in 2021, they've averaged just 1.6 goals per game and are only still in contention for the title thanks to a good defensive record, with just 4 goals conceded in the last 8 games. Those two things are no doubt connected. Especially during the injury absence of Sergio Ramos, Real offered a more cautious and controlled style of play, which meant they provided better protection to the outstanding Thibaut Courtois, but posed less attacking threat. Injuries have also been a factor. Key attacking players Benzema, Rodrigo, Fede Valverde and, of course, Eden Hazard have all missed significant playing time. And replacements such as Mariano Diaz and Hugo Duro are not, to be frank, up to the level of a title-winning team. Examining Real Madrid's problems does not really require in-depth tactical analysis. The issue is quite simple. Other than Benzema, the squad does not possess regular scorers. And although netting 3 goals in Tuesday's Champions League win over Atalanta was a very welcome development, even then it was notable that the key opener, which gave Madrid complete control of the tie, was scored, of course, by Benzema. Last season, Los Blancos were able to overcome their lack of depth in scoring and win the title in large part thanks to boasting the league's best defensive record and the relative weakness of their biggest rivals. But this time around, Atletico and Barcelona are much stronger, and Zidane's men will probably need to win at least 9 of their remaining 11 games to have a real chance of taking the title. The question is, where will the goals come from? There is only really one consistent answer. Over to you, Karim.